Hi, in this video, I will show how you can calculate the target price of CVS Health Corporation using the residual income model valuation. I am going to call it RIM, R-I-M, valuation hereafter. In the previous video, I showed how to use free cash flow valuation. If you have not watched it yet, I put the link of that video in the description below. Let's talk a little bit about RIM valuation. RIM valuation relies on the same discounted cash flow model where the numerator is the cash flow or CF. The valuation method is named after the number that you use to replace the CFs. For example, if you replace the CF with dividends, it is called discounted dividend model. If you change the CFs with free cash flow, it is called free cash flow valuation method. Finally, if you replace the CFs with a residual income or RI, it is called RIM valuation. As we have discussed in the previous video, if you applied the free cash flow valuation model to calculate stock price and the result came out to be negative, that means the company has negative free cash flow. Thus, free cash flow valuation is not appropriate. In this case, RIM valuation method can be used as an alternative. Now, what is residual income? Conceptually, residual income for a given time period is the earnings for that period in excess of the investor's required return on beginning of period investment, which is also called the equity charge. In RIM valuation method, the intrinsic value of equity is the sum of two components: the current book value of equity and the present value of expected future residual income. RIM valuations are of two types. One is single stage residual income model, which assumes that a company has a constant return on equity and constant earnings growth rate through time. It can be multi-stage residual income model as well. We will be using the multi-stage RIM model for today's exercise. And the Excel template I will use is custom designed for multi-stage model. I hope you have the template file right now. If you don't, please check the video description and I will leave a link to that template. As you can see in the Excel template, there are a lot of NAs. You are going to enter information into the yellow highlighted cells only. If you scroll down, you will see many yellow highlighted cells. I suggest you do not change any other cell information or else the template file may break. If you accidentally break the file while working, you can download a fresh copy and work right from the beginning. The template file has four sheets. The first is RIM valuation, in which you enter information and edit assumptions. The second one is key ratios, where you will paste firm's financial information. This information will come from Morningstar.com. Again, you will just fill in the yellow highlighted cells only. You will paste analyst estimates from Yahoo Finance into the third sheet. In the final sheet, you will paste the company name and beta coefficient information from Yahoo Finance as well. To summarize, we will mainly collect information from the Morningstar.com, Yahoo Finance website, and other websites, the address of which is also given in the template. All this information is for free. For today's RIM valuation exercise, I will use CVS Health Corporation. Click on the S&P 500 sheet in your template. We will fill in beta coefficient and company name here. Let's go to Yahoo Finance. Type in the ticker symbol CVS. From the summary tab, copy the name of the company by pressing Ctrl plus C on your keyboard. Go back to S&P 500 sheet, click cell C2. From the paste menu, click paste special and then text. From now on, you'll be using this paste special method when pasting information into a cell. Type in the ticker symbol as CVS. The beta coefficient is listed as 0.53 as of today. I will type this number in cell D2. The adjusted beta coefficient in cell E2 is automatically calculated. This is called Bloom adjusted beta. If you are interested, you can look that up. Let's go to the estimates sheet. Information on this sheet will come from Yahoo Finance as well. Click on the Analysis tab. We only need an estimate of earnings and revenues from here. Copy this information and paste it into cell A1 by using Paste Special menu. Now, you can resize the columns for better view. Now, click the key ratios sheet. This is where you will paste CVS's financial ratios and other information from Morningstar.com. Let's open a new browser tab and type in Morningstar.com and press enter. In the ticker symbol box, type in CVS and go to the CVS Health Corporation financial page. Now, the key ratio tab says go to Valuation and Growth. Click Valuation tab, scroll down and then click Growth. Copy the calendar years from 2014 to 2023. Click cell C4 and paste the copied information. For 10-year average EPS growth, scroll down the Morningstar page. Now, copy the 10-year average EPS . Paste this information into cell C5. For book value per share, I need to go to Valuation and then Financial Health tab. Copy the book value per share data . Paste this into cell C6. For dividend per share, I need to go to the dividend tab, copy the dividend per share data, paste this into cell C7. For year over year EPS growth, I need to go to Valuation and then Growth tab. Copy the year-over-year EPS growth data, paste this into cell C8. For the last one, earnings per share data. Morningstar has incomplete information. So, we will go to macrotrends.com. The link is given here. I will copy the link and open the website in a new browser tab. Scroll down until you see CVS Health Corporation's annual EPS. Let's copy the yearly EPS data. Now, go to the key ratios sheet. Click cell R17 and paste special the copied EPS data from MacroTrend website. I need to make an adjustment to convert the vertical data into horizontal. Click cell C22. Write a transpose formula such as equals transpose. In the parentheses, select the range R17 to S31 and then enter. I only need data from 2023 to 2024. Copy this range and paste only values in C11. Now, I can delete all this data. I think I have collected almost all the necessary data. Go to the first sheet. We will start filling the yellow highlighted cells only. Type CVS in cell B1. This should populate cell C1 with the company name. Type today's date in cell E2. For treasury yield, I will copy the website link given and open in a new browser. The US Treasury yield curve is based on the data on October 1st, which is the most recent Treasury yield data available. I will hover the mouse pointer over the third dot, and 3.74 is showing as the 10-year Treasury yield. This number can also be located in the table. Take this 3.74 and type in cell B2. For equity risk premium, I will copy the website link given and open in a new browser. Out of the three lines, the black line indicates the implied equity risk premium. Hover your mouse pointer on the edge of the line. The risk premium is 2.51. Type 2.51 in cell B4. For growth rate in dividend in cell B20, I will leave as is. Please note that revaluation model is not affected as much by dividend. For current stock price in cell C27, I will go to Yahoo Finance and collect today's market price of 62.24. Type 62.24 in cell C27. For the assumption in cell R32, I like to be conservative in my assumptions. As the current fiscal year's expected ROE is 11.31%, I will assume that this number will gradually decrease to 1% in 15 years. So, I type 1 in cell R32. As you notice, the template is designed in a way that ROE is decreasing to 1% gradually. So, for other companies, you can also assume 1% to be conservative. I think it's a reasonable assumption. For the dividend payout ratio assumption in cell H33, notice that the company has 38.91% for 2024. I will take approximately half of this number. I'm going to type 19 in cell H33. What I'm assuming here is that the current dividend payout ratio of 38.91% will gradually decline to 19% in next 5 years. And this 19% will be constant for next 10 years. The last thing you check is if all earnings estimates are populated properly. For example, the high estimate for current year is $7. The formula says estimate sheet cell D5. Visual inspection says the number is correct. We will check one more. The low estimate is $6.41. The first sheet also shows the correct number. Therefore, it looks like these numbers are populated correctly. Now that we have covered all the yellow highlighted cells, it is time to look at the target stock price and make a decision. In row 26, you have three price targets in cells B26 to D26 of about $81, $75, and $73. These price targets are based on analysts' high, mean, and low EPS estimates. These target prices of CVS are also called intrinsic value or fundamental value. Since all of these prices are greater than the current market price of 62.24, CVS Health Corporation is currently undervalued in the market. In other words, the price of CVS will increase to our target price in the near future, given that our model and assumptions are correct. Therefore, we can offer a buy recommendation for this undervalued stock that may eventually lead to a potential return of 17.8% to 30.44% in a year or more. I hope that using this template and the revaluation method shown in this video, you can estimate the target price of any public limited company and conclude whether the stock is over or undervalued. Thanks for watching this video.